We consider deep brain stimulation for patients with Parkinson's disease, usually when they're a little bit further along in their disease. The stereotypic candidate that we implant are patients who have motor fluctuations. Those are patients who take their medications and have a great response to the medication, sometimes too great. They have extra movements or dyskinesias. But then the medicines wear off in just 2 or 3 hours, then they're in an off state. And they spend their entire day going on and off their medications, sometimes unpredictably and sometimes uncontrollably. What deep brain stimulation is able to do is make the day much more even for those types of patients. So we reduce motor fluctuations. There's another category of patients with Parkinson's disease who benefit from surgery, and those are patients who have tremor dominant disease. Surgery can be extremely effective at achieving control of that tremor. The last group of patients that we often consider are those who benefit from medications but just have too many side effects from the medications. Those patients, we might also choose to proceed with deep brain stimulation a little bit earlier than we would otherwise because they just can't tolerate the medical therapies. There are two factors that we consider when recommending deep brain stimulation for someone with essential tremor. The first is how much the tremor actually bothers the patient. There are many patients who have a little bit of tremor, but they are coping with life. They're able to do everything that they want to do. If the tremor is not disabling and it's not impairing your function, and you found ways to cope with the tremor, then we really don't recommend pursuing any kind of intervention. We really want to be targeting patients for this surgery in whom the tremor is the major source of disability in their life. And if we're able to improve that tremor, that they feel like their life would be better. Deciding between focused ultrasound and deep brain stimulation therapy can be a difficult decision for some and an easy decision for others, depending on preferences. Consulting with a multidisciplinary team that has experience with both therapies is very helpful because they can help you understand what's best for you. They can consider what your individual risks might be and help point you in the right direction if there may be particular nuances to your health that should point you in one direction or another. The power of that team is in bringing those views together and providing the best possible recommendation for each patient that comes through our program.